ask them to have to do in music stuff.
When people were at the mosque during evening prayers, a huge blast occurred. So many Muslims were injured and martyred. I brought two of my family members who were injured to the hospital.
Taliban officials have now finally given figures for the casualties, both the dead and the injured, from last night's devastating explosion at a mosque in the northwest of Kabul. But given the number of casualties, including young children who were admitted to the main emergency hospital here in the center of Kabul, run by an Italian NGO, there is fear that those figures could rise even higher, heightening the concern of people here that their hopes that with the end of the Taliban war against the US-led military campaign here, that there could be greater peace and security. And there is greater peace and security across large swathes of the country. But even though no group has taken responsibility for this attack, there has been a pattern of attacks by the Islamic State group, often targeting members of the Shia Hazara minority, but also increasingly prominent religious clerics who either adhere to a different brand of Islam, a different creed, or who are strong supporters of the Taliban. There's a long-standing rift between these two Islamist groups. They're divided along ideological, religious, personal and political lines. There's long been a battle for territory and influence in Afghanistan. Islamic State has more global ambitions, the Taliban focusing more on what's happening in Afghanistan, and ever more so since they came into power last August. And Afghans look to them now for, you know, for addressing the needs of people here. So that's why the Taliban often want to, they don't welcome the attacks, but they're sometimes slow with the numbers. They don't want to create this impression that they're now failing to keep the peace here in the country, which is now under their control.